Reckon you'll be out in the woods tomorrow, Brian.
You bet your life I'll be out there.
Good luck. I hope you bag a big one.
Yeah, me too. Okay. Next time I see him stare at you like that, I'm gonna knock his block off.
Brian, you have got to watch your temper. Now, Ed and his family have been loyal customers for years. And we can't afford to lose business just because somebody's a bit of a oddball.
He's more than just an oddball. I'm sorry, Mrs. Marshall, but the guy's a creep. And he can't act that way towards you.
Well, I can handle myself around the likes of Ed Gein. Don't worry. But thank you for being so protective.
Jim, it's Brian. You gotta get over to the store real quick now because there's blood on the floor. Goddamn cash register's missing. This is just like we found Mary Hogan's place. Eddie Gein must have took her the same way that he took Mrs. Marshall.
No, wait a minute, Brian, wait. You don't know that.
He was staring at Mary and acted really weird around her before she disappeared. Well, he was doing the exact same thing to Mrs. Marshall, and now she's gone, too.
Oh, Brian, I know you're upset, but think about what you're saying. Eddie Gein? He used to babysit my kids.
He asked her to go roller skating with him and to the movies the other day. And he come in yesterday asking about antifreeze and if I was going hunting today.
It doesn't mean that he kidnapped her.